Hi there, and welcome to this video on Transactions zipForm Edition. Today, we'll be showing you how to create a transaction coordinator in your brokerage account. Let's go ahead and get started. A transaction coordinator guides a transaction from beginning to end as they assist the agent in driving their business forward. To create a transaction coordinator, we'll start by going to the Admin tab, then selecting Users. Once inside Users, click on New to begin creating the transaction coordinator. The first page we'll need to complete is general information. We'll start by setting the user role to transaction coordinator. You'll notice the third page, libraries, has disappeared. This is because a transaction coordinator will automatically assume an agent's entitlements when creating transactions for them. After choosing the role, you'll need to fill in the new transaction coordinator's information. Then click Next when you're ready to continue. The next tab is Office Information, where you can choose which offices the transaction coordinator will have access to. By default, they'll have access to the corporate office. The next tab is Products, where you can choose what products you want the transaction coordinator to have. The last section is User Permissions. This is where you can set up what degree of access and authority a transaction coordinator has. The first section at the top is Working with Transaction Type, where you can deactivate any transaction types they are not responsible for. This means they will only receive notifications for transaction types that have been activated here. In the Working with Agents Transactions area, you can activate or deactivate whichever options apply to their management authority. It's important to point out that only one of two degrees of approval rights can be selected at a time. Mark for Approval allows the transaction coordinator to mark transactions, but the agent would ultimately grant final approval. Can mark and grant approval allows the transaction coordinator to mark transactions and grant final approval. The Working on Transaction Documents permissions controls if the transaction coordinator can add and edit forms and delete signed and unsigned documents. Agent Templates controls what the transaction coordinator can do with templates. Can create means they can create their own templates, and can edit allows them to edit an agent's existing templates along with any they personally created. E-signatures allows the transaction coordinator to prep and send documents for signature. However, if deactivated, the transaction coordinator will not have e-signature rights at all. View Contacts has all selections ticked by default because the transaction coordinator will have access to the agent's contacts as well as corporate and office contacts. Transaction Contacts refers to the contacts in the party section of a transaction. Don't forget to activate All Users options to have access to all users in the various office locations. Then click Save when you're ready. If you have an existing user that you would like to transfer into the role of a transaction coordinator, simply open up an existing profile to edit, change the user role to transaction coordinator, then update the user permissions to the desired settings. When your transaction coordinator opens their account, they'll be able to see all transactions on the brokerage accounts as specified by their permissions. When they create a transaction, it will start out the same, asking what type of transaction they would like to make. To demonstrate, we'll go with a new purchaser offer. Under Transaction Information, there is now an additional Agent section. The transaction coordinator can fill in information of the transaction just like an agent normally would. After they select Agent, the Templates dropdown will now include templates used by the agent, if the permissions were set up to give that access. Once created, the transaction coordinator can begin the admin work they need to do for the transaction. Note that in the top left corner, there is a box that will show the name of the agent and the transaction coordinator for the transaction. That sums up this video on creating a transaction coordinator for brokerage accounts on Transaction zipForm Edition. For more information, we invite you to check out one of our webinars by clicking on the link in the description.